Hey, what's going on today, everybody? My name is Jeremy, and I'm the founder of Black People Eats. And I've just been thinking about this for a lot of few weeks, me and my team, and we finally came to a decision. So a lot of you all have been asking, you know, how do you build a brand? What is a brand? How can I start all of that? So we decided to come up with a plan. Well, every week we will give you guys marketing tips to build your brand. And today is our very first video. Woo! I'm super excited. You know, it's important because, you know, due to the COVID-19 situation, whether you don't have a brand at all and you want to start, or whether you're at a position where you're looking at everything that's going around and you're saying, I want to rebrand. This is for restaurant, churches, small businesses, and entrepreneurs. Any of us, it is time. If you do not have a great brand, or if you have an unstable brand, this is a time to either rebrand it or start. So this is going to be the first video, and we're just going to talk about the intro to branding. This is going to be an intro video. Now, if you already have a brand, then we're going to have some other videos going forward. But we did not want to start with all the other things until we laid the foundation first. So the first thing, why is branding important? I know a lot of times everybody talks about brand. But your brand is important is because it communicates to everybody. It communicates to people when they see you, people that's friends, people that's family, all of that. Everything is a brand, whether you believe it or not. Everything, the food we eat, the water we drink, the clothes we buy, even the spouses that we choose. You know, everybody has a brand. So the brand is important because it is going to allow people to see who you are, what you represent, what you stand for, and how they feel when they experience your brand. So branding is important because it is going to allow you, whether it's a personal brand or your business, it's going to allow those brands, it's going to show people who you are. Okay? So now that we understand why branding is important, because at the end of the day, brand is what's going to cause people to buy things. Brand is what's going to cause people to eat things. Brand is what's going to cause people to drink things. Your brand is the factor for making purchases. No matter what you say, most people, everything that they buy is because they say, ooh, that's a good brand right there. I want to buy that. Or no, that's a bad brand. Don't bring that. When you go buy me these groceries, bring me this. And that's how you want people to see you. You want people to bring you that because your brand is stellar. So now we're going to dive a little bit more into the fun things. So what is a brand? This is how I define a brand. I know everybody have their own definition, but I'm going to use you to what helped me when I was establishing. A brand to me is the label on a product. So when people see the label, what do they emotionally get? Do they get excitement? Do they get joy? Do they get sadness? Do they get anger? Do they get frustration? A brand is the label that is placed on a product. It is how people view you, how people see you, and how people feel when they see you. So, I'm very good on examples, so let's just take it like this. This bottle, well, the water's gone, but let's say the water's in here. This is just a bottle of water. That is the product, because the product is not a brand. That is the product. This label here is the brand. So when somebody see it, they say, oh, that's Jeremy's drinking water. We know that they're good. But the problem is a lot of us are coming to the world without a label, without a brand, and we're saying, hey, come get my water. Now, I found this. This is like a water my mother buys. This is Evian, okay? Most people already are trusted with their own brands. Brands of water, Evian, Fiji, Core, Essentia, right? And as you start to build a brand, without the brand, this is how you look. This bottle is $2 and this bottle is $2, right? How are you going to get people who are committed to this to start buying this? It's going to start with the brand, with the label. The label gives it the instructions, what's in it, you know, the effects of it. And without that label, which is your brand, only thing that you will look at is you will be a useless bottle. And then, so like, for example, when people see this, they say, ooh, this is 7.2 pH. Ooh, this is that. So when people see this, they say, okay, you know what? I like this brand. It's a trusted brand. It's a respected brand. I like the way it makes me feel. The last time I drank it, it was good. It was good. But the problem is, you come with a product trying to sell it. Brands sell themselves. Brands sell themselves. A good brand does not have to try to sell you anything. They just show. They just sit on the shelf. And when people see it, they say, oh, yeah, that's a good brand. It stands for excellence. It stands for quality. It stands for this. So the question is, what does your label speak about you? When people see your label, will they say, oh, I want that? Or when people see your label, will they say, nah. The label looks whack. It looks tacky. It looks this. And that's what branding is how do people see you? You know, how will people see you when they look at your brand? Ask yourself that. So I want you guys to think about something. Here's an activity. Write down what you think your brand is. If you have a business, an entrepreneur, or you're a leader, or a restaurant, anything. If you have a brand, I want you to write down, what do you think your brand is? Okay? After you write it down, I want you to ask three people that, hey, I have a brand. What do you think my brand represents? If your brand doesn't align, if what they say does not align with what you wrote down, then you're not branding right. And that's the thing. We want people to feel how we want our brand to go. So for example, like for Black People Eats, when I want to see people Black People Eats, what I want them to say, I want them to see captivating, fun, energetic, emotionally good food. That's what I want them to see. And when I see that, and when people respond, say, we love the food, we went, we tried, I'm like, man, they are seeing the brand and what we see. Now imagine if I wanted them to see that, but I posted nasty pictures of food. We're gonna be on two different playing fields. So they want us to see that we're doing the exact thing they're seeing the exact same thing that we thought about, and they're not just going far off from what it is. So there's a difference between a product and the brand. A product is something that you purchase. A brand is something that, you know, that emotional connection, how you feel. Example, when you look at let's say Apple. When you think about Apple, what's the first thing that comes to your mind? That's that brand piece. The product is the iPhone. But Apple is like, ooh, elegant, starter. Or for example, when you're looking at like the shirt on my logo, Jordan. You think of Jordan, what is the brand behind Jordan? Man, that can fly. I've seen a man win 6-0, championships, rings, boom, boom, boom. So think about this. Everything we just talked about was not his shoes. We just talked about his brand, what he stood for. And then the product is the shoes. Write this down. Your product and or service will only be as good as your brand. If you have a crappy brand, people will not want your product, even if it is a good product. Because I'm going to give you an example. McDonald's does not have the best burgers. We all can probably name 50 burger spots that's better than McDonald's. But why do people still go there? Why do people still purchase there? Why do they still sell the number one burgers? Think about that. It's their branding, that golden arch. When the kids see that, they'll just light up, right? It's the brand. So it's not always the best product that wins. It's the best brand that wins. And I want you guys to remember that. It's always about the best brand. It's not always the best product. If you come and try to sell a product without the label, without your brand, you will never be effective. You will never be effective. Now that we talked about that, you're gonna ask yourself, who is my brand for? Your brand is for. You must have a target audience, okay? Your brand is not for everybody. And that's just point blank, that's just the thing of the matter. Like when I looked at my brand, I said, okay, who will I serve? I will serve the community that wants to know where Black restaurants are. If other people do it, that's amazing. I'm grateful. But never forget that your target audience is an audience that's specific to your niche. Specific to your niche. Specific. Because a lot of times we say we want the whole pie. And that's greed. We want to narrow it down. Say, okay, within the whole pie, How many people like cherry? Okay, then the people who like cherry, how many people like this? So you want to narrow it down and say, okay, these are my clients. The people outside of this come, that's fine. But I only want the people who my brand is catered for, because those are the people who will be your support. Those are the people who will be your community. Those are the people who will give you 100%. And if we do not do that, then your brand will not succeed. Your brand will not last. You know, so that's why it's important to figure out who your market is. So I want you to write down, who would I be targeting in this market? With my brand, who would I target? Would I target men between the ages of 25 to 35? Would I target single moms? Will I target people who love the gym? Will I target people who love oranges? Will I target, you know, people? Do you know some of the most successful companies target success, just specific niche? They don't target everybody. You know, you're not gonna target everybody. Coca-Cola is targeting people who love cola drinks. Water companies are targeting people who love water. They're not trying to, because the problem is your consistent supporters in your community, your target market, if your brand is tight, they will tell everybody about your product. And that's how the brand will grow, because you focus on your small community, and your small community will do word of mouth. It will spread, and then your community will start to grow. But it grows when you focus on small. So always think, focus on the small groups, and the small groups enhance and enlarge to bigger groups. That's why I'm important. So where do I start my brand? So once you figure out, you know, what your brand is, you know, who you're going to target to, then you're going to figure, okay, where do I start it? You're going to start your brand based on the platform you think is best. Now, I would just say start all of them if you can. Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, all that. But if not, if you feel overwhelmed, and you can be, when I started Black People East, I honestly started with Instagram and Facebook. Just that, because you know you can post both together. So I started with just Instagram and Facebook. I would post twice, and it was amazing. It was amazing. And we're going to talk about a little bit more of some of the things you can do to build it. But figure out which platform do you think best will serve for you. If you can, if you have the time to do all of them, I'm going to say do all. If you can't, I'm going to say just pick one. Start that and let that grow. And then figure out, you know, which ones are you going to do more. Then the question everybody wants to know is, when do I start? Do I wait? Do I do this? And I'm going to tell you this from somebody who used to be super perfectionist, and I've even grown out of it. Start now. Don't wait. Tomorrow is not the right time. Tomorrow is not the right day. Today is the right day. Because if you wait, when you wait, what you're saying is, I want to drive around the block and see the journey before I take it. But there are certain things. If you go outside of where you are right now, you go look down the street, you will not see 1,000 miles ahead. You only may see 2-3. You won't know what the journey holds until you start. So I challenge you to start your brand today. Your restaurant, your church, your small business, you entrepreneur, you leader, you creator, you innovator, you start today. Stop waiting. Now is the time. Personal branding is what's going to be the difference maker in 2020, 2021, and years to come. Personal branding, restaurant branding, business branding is going to matter. It's what's going to distinguish you from everybody else. So I hope you guys just enjoyed this. I hope we did a great job. If you have a question specific to your brand, how to get started, email us info@blackpeopleeats.com. We're going to pick one person, and we're going to answer their question. So whatever question that's specific, email it to us. No matter whether you're a restaurant, any type of business owner, we're going to answer it on our next live feed. Next week, it is going to be fun. We're going to talk about, you know, how to start building that social brand. We're going to talk about that. So now we talked about, you know, what is a brand, why is a brand, all that stuff, why is it important? Because we need to talk about the foundation first. But next week, we're going to start delving into some more topics on how to start your brand. So my name is Jeremy Joyce of Black People East. Thank you guys, and I hope you all enjoyed this video.